the flame goes through and he actually killed the other policeman. Makes me sound even more like an idiot than usual. Okay, you probably got it by now, but that's Canal Road is the part of Wanchai where all the drug dealers and the crooks leave. Which means that it's one of the parts of the town where there's more things to do. Not surprisingly, yeah. When there's something dirty in one part of the town, Deus Ex, that always means there's a deal. Let's get rid of the sword for a moment. And let's have a deal.
Good evening, sir.
Slow night.
Not at all. Everyone requires sampan now that the triads destroyed Canal Road Tunnel.
Why'd they do that?
Fighting in the tunnel, sir. 5 nights ago, that is caved in and...
Five nights ago?
To hurt the shops.
We saw them fighting like a few hours earlier.
Yesterday, 4 Europeans arrived. Treasure hunters. They are here to dive in the ruins and loot the bodies.
Oh, come on.
Must be the year of the vulture.
Ooh, good one.
It is an ugly business, but a profitable one. They have given me a commission if I can sell the weapon mods they have already recovered. I have modifications for accuracy, reload, and...
Yeah, give me everything.
Very good.
Slow. Bye. I'll... accuracy. Reloading. Well, I don't have a choice for the no recoil. So apparently there's a megbot. Well, yes, there's a megbot. You learned in Maggot Show's flat. Works like that everywhere. Just pull the lamp and oh my god, a megbot. And that. Okay, let's open it. What do we have in here? You're kidding me, right? Boxes? Just boxes? Huh. Well, if you thought that, you thought wrong. It's actually one of the very few instances of the game when the boxes are full of stuff. Yeah, generally they don't put anything in... boxes which are not made of wood, but that's a little exception, you know, and a good one. 4 zyme and 300 credits. And if you don't know why I'm collecting the zyme, let's just say that you can't know it by now if you haven't played the game already, but zyme will actually come in handy later in the game. Okay, let's do a bit of diving and go on this good old rusty boat. I'm on a rusty boat. Open it good old fashioned way. Yeah, it's death water. Poison, so they're actually poison in here. Lot of stuff. Get back your rockets. It's not like I really cared because... Refill my energy! Refill my energy! Moons, give me strength! Talking about moons giving me strength, I'm already thinking about my next LP projects, because yeah, I want to do other ones. It's not just like Deus Ex. I don't want to do a whole lot of LPs, I just want to show games that I really know and really master. So I won't show off and just do the do. You know, I'm not doing that just for... Let me get in here! I'm not doing that just for the sake of playing. I'm actually doing that because I want to show stuff. I'm thinking of my next LP project, and I think it will be dealing with moons giving me strength. If you know what I mean. If you don't know what I mean, well, you'll discover pretty soon. Yeah, that's what I was looking for. The only other bar in the town. Looks less flashy than Lucky Money, but the barman is even classier.
Paul Denton, I have the blueprints. I must warn you, Oh.
Warn me about what?
I have made a mistake.
Paul's my brother. What's the problem?
No, I have made a mistake.
Really convincing, JC.
No, I am sorry.
Come on!
I must say nothing. They
will
kill me.
Who will kill you?
You can trust me. I really am Paul's brother. You said something about blueprints.
No, I do not know you.
Trust me.
Maybe you work for Versalife.
Let me talk to your mother!
Versalife. Good. We're getting closer. You might as well tell me the rest. If I'm gonna kill you, you are already dead.
You paid me, okay? I only did it for the money. I have the blueprints of the Versalife building, 2,000 credits. And I have the other things he wanted. The scrambler grenade for 1250, and the thermoptic camo for 4,000.
What did Paul want with Versalife?
All he said was not to get caught, and to tell nobody what I did.
Scrambling grenade for 1250? Blueprints of a building?
Check back.
You're a funny guy. Really funny. Yo, man. Classy bartender.
You're buying Wen Chai, you pay 12. Here's
yeah,
eight.
But it's crap. Nothing's about Maggie.
You know of a Maggie Chow?
Maggie Chow, a bad character. Before she was an actress. Now she's everywhere in Hong Kong politics. They say that
yeah.
She's a spy.
Who does she spy for?
No one knows. Somebody paid her a lot of money once. And one of the rares ended up floating in the canal. Dangerous to talk about.
Hmm. The bartender, lot of other things to say, but, again, like all the bad bartenders, it's, mostly about philosophical stuff. And I'm not in the mood for that. I mean, I'm fucking JC Dandan. I'm not one of these gay philosophers. Spend their days sitting around a table, sucking dicks, and saying catchy sentences. Okay, let's slide. I think that's the only part of the game that is icy and that makes you slide, but that's actually really neat. I mean, there's no use for ice in the game. But nevertheless, they developed some ice surfaces just for this part. That's really funny. Skills. Yeah, I'll upgrade my swimming for this part. Because you have to swim for a pretty long time. If you're not good at swimming and don't want to upgrade your skill, I strongly advise that you got a tool to breathe underwater. Actually, you can have two here. If you're fast, you can catch them. Or there's another way to get them. You can come from another side. I don't really remember how it works, but there's another way to catch them. But yeah, I strongly advise that you have a device to breathe, because you will be under the water for quite a long time, and there's a bunch of things around here, you know? There's krakens. You don't want to have to deal with krakens and the water if you can't breathe. Now with the dragon tooth, it's not really a problem. But if you're doing that on the first instance when you could come here without the dragon tooth, it might be a little tricky. You know the krakens? Well, those are only baby Karkins. An adult Karkin, I would not even attack him, even with a saber, the dragon tooth sword. But you know the Karkins, they have a hell lot of HPs and they're pretty strong. Okay, so you want to go here. Other places in Canal Road, you're not obliged to go. Doesn't make you get a lot of things, but here you got to come here because there's an amplifier, there's an upgrader, and gosh, you need those in the game. Let's upgrade healing. Actually, I don't heal fast enough. Back to swimming. We're actually going straight to the other side. By the way, there's fish around here. I don't really understand how they got here. I mean, it was flooded. But who imported the fish around here? I don't know. There's actually stuff on this side too. It's pretty hard to get though, and I will be short on it here. But yeah, you got to go around here, and here you go. Plus you get a few experience points. The weapon upgrader you find here is a laser. Oh, there's still one house we haven't visited yet. This is probably gonna be a long part. I'm sorry. I don't really like to do long parts, but kinda have to do that for Canal Road because there's a lot of things scattered around. And I would like to cut because that would make me earn a lot of time, but if I cut you won't see where I'm going, and you won't know where to go because there's not a lot of this district actually always look about the same. There's not really anything to know where you are precisely, so I want to show you. Let's use a lockpick. There's still a lockpick left where the boats are, so I can get it. Okay. I didn't need to do that, but just get the 20 points for exploration, get the med kit. I think there's something on this pipe. No, on this. Yeah, there's something here. Yeah, credits, 50 credits. And that's the door I tried to destroy earlier. So yeah. Yeah, I think now we've done everything we could do on Canal Road. The video is probably longer already, but there's still a little something I forgot to do in Tonochi Road. Let's meet back in Maggie's apartment, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay, back in Maggie's flat. This time when you come back, there's no one around here. No Miss Tsung, no Maggie Chow. What I forgot to do is actually to look around. On this side, you see that apparently there's something on the other side. Well, let's break the window. I don't know why. When you break the roof, there's an alarm. When you break the window, nothing happens. Well, let's activate our mode, not to take any damage. And let's get in here. Got the choice between breaking a window and lockpicking. You could break the window easily with your sword, but I don't want to break the window for a special reason you're going to see in a minute. Let's go in the other room. American flag. I wonder who lives there. Project D-Book? Accreditation? Something about a chopper? Huh. I wonder. Joke's flat. Yeah, that joke's flat. Oh my god. I've never found really anything done around here. The only good part is that well, it's a cool neat little thing, you know. You just know that Jocks really leaves somewhere. And yeah, that's the locked door you couldn't get into that I talked to you about like two episodes ago. We've done quite a bunch of crap in this episode, but that stuff we had to do, you know it, and stuff, secrets I wanted to show, speaking of stuff, I had to do that eventually in an episode. Well, that was today. Sorry for no progression in the plot. But we actually met Trust Tong, and I think it will be a pretty long video, so kind of lot of accomplishments for today. Next time we'll go into First Alive, as I said already three times. I still haven't found the catchphrase for my outro, so until next time, bear to say, see you next.